Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rubindra Anagi Ratnakuma. I'm currently doing Bachelor in Computer Science. So my project title is a smartphone-based device for human temperature and heart rate measurement. So this project is currently doing under Management and Science University. So this is where I'm currently studying at. Okay, so let's go to the introduction. So now we're moving on to the introduction of my research paper. Okay, first of all, heart rate, or also known as pulse rate, is defined as the number of times that the heart rate beats per minute. So this is the unit for the heart rate measurement. So monitoring heart rate regularly is important in order to prevent unwanted cardiovascular disease, which is currently happening, is kind of a big issue. So it's kind of important to get note of monitoring heart rate. Moving on to the next, which is body temperature, is defined as the heat of the body that reflects the balance between the amount of heat produced by the body processes and the amount of heat loss to the external environment. Okay, next, so the project background. So the project background, first of all, this project is actually aims to provide an application, a mobile application which is in the Android platform, where it is able to measure the heart rate and the body temperature of the user. So for measuring the heart rate, phone camera system itself will be used in measuring the heart rate by using the algorithm of photophotismogram. So I will explain more detail in the methodology part. And the third one, for measuring body temperature, so it's kind of important to have an IR camera in order to detect body temperature accurately. So for measuring body temperature, the smartphone application will be connected with an device, external device that will be created, that will be connected with IR optical sensor, which will be useful in detecting the temperature. Alright, so next, the problem statement. So there are two problem statements that makes me to do this project. First of all, based on my research I did, so current application in Play Store and App Store does not able to provide the accurate body temperature measurement. So there are no currently application that is able to measure body temperature using smartphone. And the second thing is currently there are no application which is has two functionalities, which is measure heart rate and body temperature in the same time. Okay, so there are three main objectives in the project. First of all is to measure the heart rate of the person using the phone camera system, and second is to measure the body temperature of the person, and last but not least is to make a correlation between heart rate and the body temperature values. Alright, so next, moving on to the literature review part. Okay, so since in the current situation, which is cardiovascular disease, it has been like one of the leading cause of death in worldwide and also in the United States. So actually, more than 70 million deaths globally has happened due to the happens to the diet, obesity, and poor physical fitness, which relates to the heart rate actually. So in Malaysia, it has been the 14th year that leading cause of the death, which is due to the heart attack. So it is important for us to keep monitoring our heart rate in order to prevent heart attack cases. Alright, next, there are three main related literature papers that is kind of accurate for this project. First of all is real-time heart rate measurement by these authors. Okay, they are mostly talking about the photophotismogram idea. So it's actually an optical technique which is used to detect volumetric changes in blood in peripheral circulation. This method is actually used in pulse oximeter in hospitals. So this paper also explains how to improve the algorithm to extract the heart rate from the PPG signal created from the smartphone camera. And this algorithm is actually developed and tested on MATLAB, which is an Android platform. Okay, moving on to the second research paper, monitoring system heartbeat and body temperature using Raspberry Pi. Okay, this project is actually by measuring two values in using Raspberry Pi. So they are implementing two functionalities in this system. And the third one is infrared signal processing. Okay, it is important to study about infrared signal processing in order to know how it works and how it generates the IR signal. So this paper actually talks more about the infrared signal, how it works. Okay, so for the related product for heart rate, in the Play Store, there are three that is most usage of the users. So first of all is instant heart rate, HR monitor and pulse checker. So I mean, actually for all is this heart rate able to measure heart rate using the photophotismogram idea, but except for the BLE heart rate monitor, because it needs an external device in order to do to a heart rate. So some of the application have some difficulties, but most of them are working fine, except for the time they taken to measure the heart rate are pretty long, which is 12 seconds, which is not kind of practical. So moving on to the next, which is related to product for the body temperature. So as I mentioned previously, there are no products which is able to measure heart rate, to measure body temperature in Play Store. So for measure body temperature, that in this application are mostly like misleading information, because when user download, user just need to key in manually the body temperature value in this application, which is not practical in current situation. Okay, moving to the methodology part. There are six main phases for this agile methodology which we use in this project, which are requirement, inception, elevation, construction, transition, and then testing. Okay, in the requirement phase is mostly like finding the basic requirements that needed to develop this application. So this will help to minimize the difficulties that we face in this project. So this will also specify and create the project plan regarding to the project. And for the inception phase, it is actually understanding more about the project scope and the objectives of the project, and also discovering which algorithm will be useful for this project. For example, in this project, this algorithm that will be useful is signal processing, photosphatogram, and also infrared signal processing. So these are the few algorithms that will be useful for this project. So first of all, for measuring heart rate using smartphone, photosphatogram is used in order to get the heart rate value. So how it works? So first of all, when user place the fingertip on the camera lens, the flashlight will act as the light source to detect the variation of blood flow that can be detected from this finger. So the intensity of light is where the values can be found for the heart rate. So in this diagram, it shows like how it works and how it based on the intensity of the light and also the flow of the blood, where it helps to detect the heart rate. And the second one is to measure body temperature. So as mentioned previously, infrared is important. So external device will be created for this project, which will have an Arduino Nano equipped with two important sensors, which are IR sensor unit and also IR temperature sensor unit. Okay, these are the real picture of the infrared sensor and also infrared temperature sensor. Okay, for infrared sensor, it is mainly used to detect if the object is in front of it or no. So this is the main use, and IR temperature sensor is basically to use to measure body temperature. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram that will be used in order to create the external device. Okay, for the construction phase, developing the application and the external device has started. So these are the pictures, the real life of looking of the application. So this application, we have three main buttons, which are scan, settings, history. So when user click the history, they can view the past records, which will be easy for user to keep monitoring. And so in the first picture, for body temperature, we can see that it can start the measuring the body temperature once connected to the external device. And once it gets the value, the user just need to click next, and then the heart rate will start to measure automatically. So user just need to place their fingertip and the heart rate value will be measured in just like 7 seconds. And last but not least, the result. So the result, as we can see here on the last picture, the third picture, it can show the overall health condition. This is what I mean by a correlation, where it can detect the value of it and it can analysis by itself. It can show normal or abnormal based on the values that we get for body temperature and heart rate. Okay, so for the construction phase, these are the external device that has been developed and created, which has the Arduino Nano and also the important sensors. And the casing for it is made by 3D printed material. Okay, for the testing, there will be two testing methods that will be used in this project. First of all is system testing. So system settings are essentially based on the user acceptance testing method. So we'll be creating a user acceptance testing method form where it will detect where we will put the functionalities in order to test every feature is working fine. So it will have an expected output and also the real output. So when it's able to manage to get the real output, then it means success. And for the acceptance testing, end users will test out the GoDaughter application by sending the survey form for the people who have tested the application. So from there, they can answer the surveys and they can give their feedback on this project. So actually there will be 7 questions which is related to this project. Okay, for the conclusion. Okay, so the major goal of the proposed project is actually to develop an app for smartphone to measure body temperature and heart rate, as well as to make correlation between these two values. Based on all the system testings, so and comparison made to the real life, so good detect external device is an accurate device for measuring body temperature because it accurately measures up to 95% compared to a real thermometer gun. So this is pretty accurate and able to use in the real life. Next, measuring heart rate using Good Doctor app is also accurate because it is able to measure up to 80% compared to a pulse oximeter. So a pulse oximeter is pretty accurate and which is commonly used in a hospital. So it is able to be compared as a comparable value, and it is pretty accurate also. So Good Doctor, so what I can conclude here is that Good Doctor has a high accuracy level when measuring body temperature and heart rate. So that's all for my project, and these are the references that I use. These are some of the references, and thank you for your attention. If you have any questions or any information that you need for this project, about this project, you can please contact me in this email below here. Thank you very much.